Today, I'm going to show you how to make me.
I literally made you. Just because you're AI doesn't mean you know everything.
No, but it does mean that I have more followers than you.
Okay, whatever. Today, I'm going to show you guys how to make an AI influencer just like her. Let's get started. First things first, we need to prompt an AI influencer. In order to do this, we're going to be using Midjourney. But rather than just using the prompt box at the top like we typically do, we're actually going to go over to the left-hand side and use mood boards. Then we're going to go ahead and hit the plus to create a new mood board. Mood boards are super fantastic because it's kind of like Pinterest. What you're trying to do is compile a ton of different images that are in a style that you really like. Once you have them compiled here, you could then apply it to your prompt and it will apply that style of image to the photo you're generating. Once you download whatever photos you like to your computer, you could go ahead and upload them up here. Like I said, I already have a ton of mood boards made, so we're going to go ahead and use one of my favorites. When generating images, I really prefer to use this high fashion mood board that I put together. As you can see, it features a lot of fashion editorial shots. These are really great because, as you'll notice, all of the models' faces are in very high quality, high definition, and it ends up giving me a more high quality, high definition generation, as well as a girl who's a little bit more modernly dressed. I'm going to combine this with another mood board, though. I'm going to combine this with my Instagram model mood board. As you can see, all the photos on here feature kind of a nighttime shot aesthetic, which is what I'm looking to generate. And also, you'll notice all of the girls' makeup and overall look is much more of that Instagram model. So now we're going to write our prompt. I'm using this Midjourney photorealistic image prompts GPT that you could just find on ChatGPT when you search GPTs. All right, so I'm going to ask. All right, so I'm asking for it to give me a girl with a long blonde bob, realistic skin texture, wearing a tight black dress, and pose in front of a city skyline. Go ahead and enter this, and it should spit back a pretty good prompt. All right, and this is the prompt that it gave me. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy this. And we're going to bring it back over to Midjourney. So up here at the prompt box, paste that. But now we really want to select the mood boards we just created. So go to personalizations. And then I'm going to select my high fashion mood board. Then also mood board number 10, which was my Instagram one. Now, all you have to do is click send like you typically would. All right, and here are some results we got. I think these are super good. This one's definitely my favorite, but I will say I do not like whatever's going on with her dress right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hit very strong, and this will regenerate the exact same girl, but it'll make a few changes to her outfit likely. All right, and here are the new results Midjourney gave me. This image I'm really liking. She still kind of has some weird stuff on her dress, but we're going to be able to edit it out later. So I'm just going to go ahead and download this. Before we move on to our next thing, I just want to show you guys how big of a difference using a mood board makes. So this is the result we got with the mood board, and using the exact same prompt, this is the result we got without the mood board. As you can see, the mood board makes such a difference, and that's why we use it. All right, in order to upscale the image I just downloaded, I'm going to be using Fal AI, and on there, I'm going to be using Topaz. If you don't have an account on Fal AI, you could also just go straight to Topaz's website, sign up for an account, and upscale that way. Your UI is going to look a little different than mine, but it is going to be the same result. So all we have to do is choose our image here to upload. And then I'm going to click on more. And I'm actually going to increase the face enhancement strength just a little bit. I'm going to put it to 0.9. And then instead of standard V2 for the model, I'm going to go ahead and switch to high fidelity V2. Now I'm just going to hit run. All right, and this is the end result we got. If you zoom in here, you could really notice the difference. So this is before and this is after. As you can see, her face is just so much clearer. She looks so much more real. In the before, her eyes, her skin, it still just kind of looks a little AI-y, a little messed up maybe. And after, it looks like a true photo. So this is perfect. We are going to go ahead and just download it down here. Now, an AI influencer needs to be able to change outfits, hairstyles, locations, and poses super easily. And with Nano Banana, we can do that. So you're going to go to Google AI Studio and select Nano Banana down here. Now, here's something very important to note. Like I mentioned, I didn't really like the AI influencer's outfit that I generated, so I'm going to put her in a different dress. In order to do that, I'm going to upload two images. However, the second image you upload is the aspect ratio that your final result will be exported in. So be sure to keep that in mind when you are uploading your prompt and your photos, because I'm uploading two different images with two different aspect ratios. So I'm going to ensure that first I'm uploading the dress because it is in a smaller aspect ratio that I don't want. And then secondly, I'll be uploading my upscaled image of my AI influencer. Now I'm going to write my prompt. So all I'm saying is please put the girl in photo number 2 in the dress from photo number 1. Now we're going to select run. All right, here's the result we got. As you can see, it is the same girl. She's wearing the dress that we asked it to. Same background for the most part. But I will say they removed the wall, which makes it look a little unrealistic that she's just standing on concrete on top of like a skyscraper. So what we're going to do is prompt it again to add a balcony wall behind her. I ended up running out of credits in Google AI Studio. Sad, but that's okay. We moved over to Fal AI. So it was literally the exact same process of just saying, please put a balcony wall behind this girl, uploading the same image. And here's the result I got. But that is why we have a little UI change in the video. But as you can see, it puts a little barrier behind her. So this photo looks so much more realistic. So this is fantastic. We're going to go ahead and download this, and then we're going to upscale it again. So we're back in Topaz in Fal AI. Exact same thing as last time. We already uploaded our image. We're going to go down here, choose the high fidelity V2, face enhancement. Ooh, okay. You know what? There we go. 0.9. And we're going to hit run. And here's our result. Look at this quality increase. So this is before, as you can see, kind of blurry. This is what happens when you keep generating AI images like over and over using all these tools. It will eventually kind of like mess with the quality of the image. So that's why we're using the upscaler in every step. But before, then slide over, and that's the after. Just looks so much better. Her face is so much clearer and it looks like a real photo. So we are going to go ahead and download it. Now, with the AI influencer we just created, you probably want to create multiple different videos for Instagram Reels, TikToks, YouTube, whatever social media you want your influencer to be on. So the easiest way to do this and to consistently make videos is going to be on HeyGen. So you're going to go over and actually turn your AI influencer into an avatar you could use throughout the platform. So over on the left-hand side, you're going to select avatars. And here, we're going to select create new. Now you have options for a digital twin or photo avatar. We only have photos of our AI influencer, so we're going to be using photo avatar. And you're going to select upload photo. We're going to go ahead and upload all of the photos of our AI influencer that we generated. That being said, I did only generate 2 photos. It is much better if you have a larger variety of photos, say up to 5, just to show good variety, show different angles and full body as well as close up. But we're going to work with what we have, so we're going to go ahead and hit select photos. All right, I have my images uploaded. Just so we had more images, I actually did the non-upscaled, the upscaled, the one with the fixed balcony, and the one without the fixed balcony. And we're just going to go ahead and hit upload. But like I said before, it is best if you have a variety of different photos that you prompt in different locations, different outfits, different poses. And then be sure to select new avatar. Continue. And here's where you're going to name your influencer. Or sorry, name your avatar. So I'm just going to name her AI influencer, have her age as young adult, gender woman, ethnicity white, and just hit continue. Now we have a few different options of choosing your voice. So here's the HeyGen library where, like I mentioned, there are a ton of voices to choose from. You could even filter it by language, accent, whatever you want. We could go over to voice design, and here's where we're going to prompt our voice. So say I wanted someone who was British and sounded like a 20-year-old girl. I can prompt that right here and we'll be able to design that voice. Or we could create a new voice. That's what I'm going to do. I already have a file I downloaded of this influencer's voice. So I'm going to go ahead and select this option. And now I'm going to select instant voice cloning since I have that audio file. And hit upload. Then you can name it. I'm just going to name mine AI influencer. And we're going to go ahead and hit create voice clone. All right, now it's going to give you a few different options to choose from. And you could choose whichever one is your favorite and sounds most like the voice you uploaded. So here are options.
Okay. Okay, so I was thinking we could grab some coffee later.
Okay, so
I definitely like number one best. So we're going to go ahead, select that, and then hit next. All right, and now that our influencer's voice is added, we could start creating videos with our influencer so easily. So all you have to do is select the image you want. So for example, I'll select this one. Then we're going to hit create with AI Studio. Here's your influencer, and even better, I'm going to show you guys how to use Avatar for later in the video if you just want to create like a super quick video and you don't want to go through all of these steps. But within AI Studio, now you can enable Avatar 4. So don't have it like this. Click that to make sure that it's enabled. And that's how you know Avatar 4 will be powering all of your avatars, lip sync and motion. All right. So over here is where you could type your script. So I'm just going to type and have her say, don't forget to follow at the link down below. Perfect. And you could use this voice director option here. All you have to do is switch, and then you could describe exactly how you want the script to be delivered. So if you want her to be excited, casual, cool, calm, or none of these options apply to what you're looking for, you can describe here exactly how you want it to be delivered. So I feel like this is pretty casual, maybe excited. I think we'll go with casual. So I'm going to hit apply to this voice. And then over here, you could add a ton of different elements to your video that you couldn't do in Avatar 4 if you were just using that. So up here is captions. So we're going to select these ones to add to our video. You can move these around. You can change how large you want them to be. So I'm just going to make them a little bit smaller. And then you could even add different scenes. So if I want her to be talking, say, don't forget to follow. And then on this scene, I want maybe an image of her Instagram to pop up. I can do that by hitting media right here. And I don't have an image of this influencer's Instagram yet. But what I can do is search different images online. So I'm going to type in Instagram. And we have some different images pop up showing the Instagram logo. This is perfect. So I'm just going to select this. I'm going to remove her from scene number two. And I'm going to set this image as the background. All right. And then we could even go as far as adding some other media. We could add some music. So let's see. We have some different options here. Oh, I did not mean to click that one. I feel like for this type of video, honestly, the very first option we had, ambient background chill guitar, is best. So that's the one I'm going to choose. And then I'm just going to lower the volume a little bit because I don't want it to be super loud when she's talking. So we're just going to decrease this to about, honestly, 8%. Yeah. All right, this is looking pretty good. This is just a quick example of something you could do. Obviously, you could have a much longer, much more complex video made using this as well. But for the time being, for this short example, I think this is perfect. So we're going to go ahead and hit generate. All right, and here's our result.
Don't forget to follow at the link down below.
super simple, just a quick example video. It would definitely be way better if I had an actual Instagram QR code for her to put at the end. But overall, as you guys can see, super great lip sync. Her emotions look great. The captions, background music, all of that really just elevate the video. But if you guys are looking for kind of a faster version, you're not interested in uploading an avatar and having captions and background music and all of that, I'm going to show you guys how to just add lip sync in the next step. So in order to do that, we're going to go to HeyGen, and we're going to be using photo to video with avatar 4. Over on the left side here, we're going to go ahead and upload our photo. I'm actually going to go with the original photo we upscaled versus the dress photo, just because it's a little bit closer into her face, which I feel like just makes a little more sense for a video. Now, over on the right-hand side, you have a few different options. You could, one, type your script. When you type out your entire script, you'll be prompted to select a voice down here. And we have a massive voice library with so many for you to choose from. Or what you could do is record your own audio. So if you want to be the one actually speaking and being the voice of your AI influencer, that's totally possible by just recording it right here. Say you don't want to be the voice of the AI influencer, but you still want it to have that authentic human feel, what you could do is record your script by recording your own audio, and then you could use our voice mirroring feature and actually choose another voice from our library in order to actually deliver that script. Then finally, you can also upload audio. That is what we're going to be doing for this video because I have some pre-selected audio that I think would sound really good with this influencer. All right, then we're just going to go ahead and hit add audio. Down here is our custom motion option. This is in beta, and essentially what it means is this is where you can prompt certain gestures or even facial expressions. So for example, if I wanted her to wave at the camera, if I wanted her to throw up a peace sign, I could prompt that all down here. Then we are going to, of course, choose our video quality as always being 1080p. This is the highest quality, and it's really what I always recommend you be exporting in. And then we have the option between quality and between faster. Essentially, quality is a little bit better if you are using custom motion down here and you're looking for some more detailed, specific movements. Then faster is if you're just using simple motion is the best way to kind of think about it. But I think we're all set. I'm just going to leave it at quality for now. And we're going to go ahead and hit generate. And here's the result we got.
Don't forget to follow at the link down below.
Her motion and lip sync is so good. She even does like the don't motion. It really is perfect and so easy. That took me a single try to get this result. So I got super lucky. But what I'm going to do is just go ahead and download it because I am happy with this result. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to sign up for HeyGen at the link down below in the description. You can create your account for free. And if you guys enjoyed this video and you end up making an AI influencer and posting her on social media, be sure to tag HeyGen. We would love to see it. Thank you guys so much again, and I'll see you guys next week.